Is your CPU performing as it should? Was the GPU upgrade really worth it? Can your machine even handle Vray? It can be hard to know if your hardware is performing as intended, especially when you don't have a reference point. And that's where benchmarking comes in handy. Today I'm going to show you how to benchmark your hardware with Vray for free. That's coming up. Hello YouTube, I am Kevin the Dane, and on this channel I'm giving you tips, tricks and tutorials to help you master Vray and 3D Studio Max. Today I have a quick tip for you on how to benchmark your CPU and GPU with Vray. And the best part is, it's free and you don't even need a copy of Vray for this to work. All we really need is a web browser, so jump over into your favorite browser and get ready. Unless of course your favorite browser is Internet Explorer, then go download Google Chrome first.
Psst. It was just a joke.
Just start by following the link in the description to Vray's benchmark tool. If you are not logged into your Cache Group account, you'll be prompted to do so. If you don't have an account, you can just create one. You don't have to be a customer to do this. When you are logged in, click the download button and just wait for the download to finish. Run the file and it will pop up with some terms. It looks just like the Vray installer, but it won't install anything. So just speed read all of this stuff and click I agree. The application will now run and you will see a couple of timers and two check buttons. You can choose to benchmark only your CPU, or just the GPU, or run both in sequence. Hit the start button and the benchmark begins. It's a good idea to refrain from using the computer while the benchmark is running, to not put unnecessary strain on the system. When the first scene is done rendering on the CPU, then the next scene will start to render on the GPU, and when both are done, you will have your results. I'd like to think that the scenes are similar in complexity and that we can compare the CPU to the GPU directly, but I can't find any info on that, so this is just a conjecture on my part. Now you can choose to share the results, and then you are taken to the benchmark page of the Chaos Group's website. Here you can see your scores contra scores from other people. It's sorted after CPU speed per default, but you can just switch it to GPU if you are more interested in that. We see here that the Quadro M6000 is performing similarly to a GTX 1070. If we want to compare to other cards of the same type, we just use the search field to filter the results. Bear in mind that some entries have multiple GPUs in the system, so you need to look for test results with the same amount of cards as your own system if you want to compare the two. We see here that the other M6000s are ever so slightly faster than mine. Perhaps this is due to my card being used for capture at the same time. If you haven't tried out Vray yet, you could go ahead and get a free trial right here on Chaos Group's website. I really hope that you learned something today, and if you did, why not pay it forward and share this video with your struggling artist friends that we may lift each other up in, you know what I mean. And as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, share, tweet, whatever floats your boat, and cut! I really hope you're... it's free and you don't even... Today I have a quick tip for you on how to... Today I have a quick tip for you on how to... Fuck it. Vi tager den gamle, den var god. Booyah!